time for another What I Eat in a Day. So starting off with breakfast, I'm making this kind of French toast type thing, but vegan style. So those are all the ingredients you'll need, and let's get on to making this. As always, the recipes will be in the description and all the amounts of everything so that you can follow along. So I'm just putting in the banana, the peanut butter, cashew milk. You can use almond milk, silk milk, any kind of non-dairy milk. Then add some flax seed. This is gonna thicken it up, and a little bit of vanilla extract. I'm also throwing in some blueberries because I don't know why, but I am. And this isn't my recipe. I'll link who created the recipe in the down bar. So it's not my recipe, but I just wanted to make this for breakfast. And also I'm drinking a ton of water just to stay hydrated because it's really hot outside and I'm going for a bike ride soon, as you will see later on. What would French toast be without some Canadian maple syrup? And I get mine locally, very delicious and natural, love it. And I'm putting some strawberries over top just to finish everything off, and this was super, super delicious. I'm feeling electric tonight. Moving on to lunch, just doing a simple smoothie, getting all that energy. So bananas, frozen fruit, spinach, kale, hemp hearts or hemp seeds, and that's it. Made just a tiny little tofurkey sandwich for me and my sister because it's really yummy. Not the healthiest thing, but whatever. So there's a little bakery downtown, and me and my sister just rode our bikes to the little donut shop, and the donuts are super delicious, so it was worth the 2-hour bike ride. But yeah, we went through a bunch of different trails, so it was really pretty and fun, and we were exhausted because we had to go up this hill on the way home. It was so steep, but yeah. Got the Reese's peanut butter cup donut. Doesn't that look amazing? It was really, really good. And I haven't had a Reese cup since I went vegan, so it tasted spot on. And I am obsessed with peanut butter, so great. Now on to dinner. I was trying something new with this sauce, so I just soaked some cranberries, cashews, some berries in a little bit of water overnight to make them softer for the sauce. Then go ahead and cut up some onions, portabella mushrooms into long strips, and garlic over a little bit of oil. And I sprinkled some basil over top of that, dried basil, and paprika, because it makes it taste really, really good when you just saute that for a little bit. And then I just threw in the onions a little bit later and let that cook for a while. After about 5-10 minutes, throw in your portabella mushrooms and a little bit of lime juice. This gives it a nice flavor. So we just grew these cherry tomatoes in our garden and they were ready, and I wanted to put them into the recipe. Obviously, there wasn't that many, but for this recipe, I suggest using a lot more. Now for the sauce, I think I added a little bit too much water. It came out a little too runny. That's why I added sunflower seed. Then I added a little bit of maple syrup towards the end for a touch of sweetness. Now onto the pan, I added some yellow peppers and kale into the mix. Let that cook just a little bit. You want to add the kale towards the end because then it'll just cook nicely and it won't go kind of brown and gross. So I'm putting all this mixture into a pita. You can have as many of these as you want, and then just put the sauce over top and you're done. That is everything. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you liked it. As always, subscribe if you did, and I'll see you guys next time.